Hello, everyone. Welcome to Relationship Talk with Sharonda. My name is Sharonda Parker, and I am your host. And, of course, as promised, I have to let y'all know that my husband was not impressed. He was not impressed with the coochie wig at all. He was more so mortified. He was like, oh, hell no. This ain't it, sis. You done came with a lot of shit, but this ain't it. But let me just tell you this here, you know, mine was bedazzled. I brought the extra one because the one that I bedazzled is a pink one. And for those of you all that are interested in just maybe, you know, doing something new, you can go on Amazon because it's not something that I'm going to carry in the store. You can go on Amazon and order what's called a kitty carpet. And it is a merkin. And we know that the merkin is a coochie wig, a vaginal wig. And this is what your girl look like. Yeah, this is what she look like. If you want to see what she look like, this is what she look like. You can fluff her up. She's shaggy. And I had a pink one like this. She's shaggy, y'all. She's shaggy. You can play all up in that thing. He can take his nose hair and go all up in that thing. But let me just tell you something. See, my husband not a fan of hair. Anyway, you know, for him, it's just like, you know, this ain't the 80s. You know, he just not a fan of hair. And I never introduced it to him like this. So he like, this don't even look like my girl. So anyway, just so you know, when you buy this, it's going to come with the actual merkin wig. And it's real soft, y'all. Real, real soft. Right, they come in different colors, okay, but they also come with the double-sided tape. Now, when I bedazzled mine, right, initially I wanted to cover the whole thing in bedazzles, but what I realized was the bedazzles made the merkin really heavy. So what we decided to do was, and I'm saying we because my daughter Taylor, she's an artist, so I had to go in and enlist some help from my soon-to-be 18-year-old. See, in my household, everybody know that their husbands and wives are intimate with one another. And they also know that you have to keep it fun and interesting and exciting. Like, these are not unfamiliar conversations that, you know, I have with my daughters because I have daughters. So they understand that when you're a wife, you have a certain obligation. That's the word I use, obligation. You have a certain obligation, okay? Wifely duties. Those are the things that that keep your marriage going. So anyway, what we realized was the bedazzles made the merkin heavy. By it being heavy, it will cause the double-sided tape not to stick, okay? So I'm just going to let you know, I am completely bald, so that means that I didn't have to worry about the double-sided tape sticking to hair and all of this kind of stuff, so I didn't have to worry about it hurting upon removal. But I'm just letting y'all know that Mr. Parker was not impressed with the merkin. And he was like, next. So being that he was not impressed, you know, I ain't feel no type of way about it. Because at the end of the day, whatever I do, it's all in fun. And either we like it or either we don't like it. And this is not the first thing that we've tried that one of us just didn't really care for. You know, cool. I did get some feedback from a customer. Because if you came to the PPG store this week, you might have caught me here because I actually worked the store this week. And she was planning a date night. She wanted to do something different. And she actually just sent me a message last night saying how her husband was so impressed with her glow-in-the-dark lingerie because that was the first thing that he saw was the glow-in-the-dark lingerie. And then she put the glow-in-the-dark toys on the nightstand. And he actually was able to pick from which toy he wanted to use first. So he was just so excited with this whole glow-in-the-dark concept. The next day he told her like how he just really enjoyed how much thought that she put into this whole glow-in-the-dark thing. But she sent me a message and was like, look, he gave me the credit for the thought, but I just want to let you know, keep doing what you're doing because my husband was really impressed. So again, my husband was not impressed with the merkin. Her husband was impressed with the glow-in-the-dark. So, yes, we do have the glow-in-the-dark stuff here at the store. All of this is the glow-in-the-dark double cock ring. the glow in the dark tongue dinger, the one that you wear in your mouth, and then the glow in the dark frisky finger. All of this is on the website. And then we have the glow in the dark panties. Yes, we do. Okay, so now that we done got all of that out the way, yes. Let me just say this to my ladies who are married. First of all, if you subscribe to my email, then you should have got an email from me this morning about the adult coloring. So, me and Spencer actually went to adult coloring at the library. It was cool. We just so happened to be there with a bunch of senior citizens doing the adult coloring. So, when I saw that the wholesale company actually came out with adult coloring books, I actually ordered some, and one of the coloring books says "Suck My Crayon." Y'all, I thought that was so cute. So you should have gotten an email from me this morning that says "Suck My Crayon." That is basically introducing the adult coloring books, because it's a possibility that we may be getting shut down again. And what people found during the time that we were on lockdown was puzzles sold out, coloring books sold out, all of this kind of stuff. So with the coloring books that I ordered, you could go in and color the pages, and then y'all can go and recreate it in your bedroom. Y'all can go recreate them scenes in your bedroom. Or if you want to do some other back-to-school stuff, we got the teacher outfit, and we got the naughty schoolgirl outfits too, okay? But y'all see Auntie is dressed down today, meaning dressed down. I should show y'all my feet. Y'all see I got on rain boots because I'm about to go mud riding with my husband. And I want to talk to my wives, especially my wives. Men have a tendency to like to be able to teach the women that they are with. They like to be able to teach us things, okay? Men enjoy when they can teach a woman something. Mud riding is really not my thing. Being playing in the mud and the dirt and all that, you know, I'm a I don't want to say like a girly girl, but you know, it ain't my thing. But let me just say this. When your husband have certain things that he enjoy doing, hobbies, whether it's fishing or whatever it is, even if it's outdoor stuff, and you one of them people that you don't like outside, you don't like all that sweating and all that kind of, suck that shit up. Suck it up, go along, enjoy. When you get there, don't be complaining the whole time and all of that kind of stuff. Go and enjoy yourself and spend time with your husband, your boyfriend, your fiance, whoever he is, doing some of the things that he enjoyed doing. Because see, what you don't understand is they always got people. I used to work with this woman, and she used to always love doing everything that the wife didn't enjoy doing. In other words, she'd just be like, oh, she ain't got to do it. Oh, she ain't got to go sit on the fishing pond. Baby, I go sit on the fishing pond with him and talk. Oh, she ain't got to enjoy doing this, sit at the other with him. I do it. And I'm saying that to say, a lot of times couples connect over what it is that the person have interest in. And just because the mud riding ain't my number one thing for us to do, sometimes we got to do things that he enjoy doing. Because I have different things that I enjoy doing. I enjoy the museums, the arts, the learning, the history, and all of that. Y'all know that's what I like, right? Well, he enjoyed this outdoors type of thing. So guess what? Ain't he about to leave him? Ain't he about to go get in this hot truck that ain't got no air? Because that's what the four-wheeler loaded up on, Big Blue. And ain't he about to go and spend a day with her husband doing what her husband enjoys doing? You don't get a lot of time here with people. So when you get the opportunity to spend time with your spouse, especially people like us, we entrepreneurs. But a lot of y'all work jobs and stuff like that. You have to actually go into a workplace. When you get free time and an opportunity to be able to spend with each other and connect with each other, even if it's just your date night or whatever it is, take that time and do the thing that the other person want to do sometimes. In other words, if your husband say, look, they got this blues concert, or I like Zydeco, and I like trail rides, or I like whatever. I like the jazz club, the piano bar, whatever. Even if it ain't your cup of tea, go. See, like me, I'm not really a jazz person. My husband is a jazz person. I'm a blues person. He don't really care for the blues, but guess what? He'll go and listen to the blues for me. He'll get up there and try to two-step with me, even though I can't dance either. But I love to get on the dance floor, even though I can't dance. So I'm just trying to get you to understand that sometimes you have to do things that the other person enjoy doing. You got to keep in mind, they got people, y'all, in my wife group, we got this assignment that I just put out there. And the assignment is, a lot of times when we first met our husbands or the people that we looked at them as a blessing, right? But when people become a part of our normal everyday life, sometimes we don't really look at them as a blessing anymore. Sometimes you even look at them more of a burden than a blessing. So we're actually putting thought into, is your husband, do you still look at your husband as a blessing? Or are you looking at him more of a burden at this point? At what point in your relationship did it change from blessing to burden? What happened? Did he change? Did you change? What changed? In other words, why did the thought process change from blessing to burden? Let me tell you something. A lot of times, it's our thought process. In other words, it's just like a new car. When you get that new car, you take care of it. You go wash it. You go vacuum it. You go do everything. Can't nobody eat in it. You don't know about the smoke in it and all this kind of stuff. Then once the new car becomes the norm to you, you notice that you eating french fries. You got a drink. Now the children got a drink. The children got french fries. Now when your brother ride, he can roll a window down and smoke. In other words, this car done became the norm and it's no longer the blessing. So I want you to go back to that point in time where you looked at it as your blessing. In other words, what was going on in your life when you looked at it as your blessing? When you got the car, was you walking? And then when you got it, it was your blessing? Or when you got the car, did you have one that was older and this was an upgrade from what you had? Do the same thing with your husband. What was going on in your life when he came into your life that made you look at him as the blessing? Did he come and take you and your children out of a situation? Were you able to go back to school because he freed up your time, but now you got your degree and your education and your job? Things are looking different. This is what goes on in my wife group. But that's a whole nother level of thinking, okay? These are some of the things that we talk about in wife school, okay? But again, if your husband, spouse, whoever want to go and do some stuff, you make yourself available and go and do some of the things that they enjoy, okay? That's going to wrap it up for today, y'all. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. If any of this stuff that you like, go to the website at the bottom and make your selections with this glow-in-the-dark stuff, okay? And again, you can find this kitty carpet, the Merkin wig. It is on Amazon. And normally they can get it to you within the next day, all right? You all be blessed. You all enjoy your Friday.